there's a filter for your vibration.
So can you go to that part again?
Or later, you slowly man, you want to learn the export.
So don't jump around. So if let's say you want to see your value, right, 这些都是你的那些 real value 咯，看到吗？ 它一直在下一点点， 你看到它在下, the whole trend.
So there is Catman AP.
Oh, it's just one Catman only. One is called analysis, the other one is a data acquisition. Actually both are together one.
In one program.
In one program. Okay. In one program. So this is the data, but if you want the data to be in number form, right, you want to export, you need to export, then you see, export, and then depend what channel you want. Let's say you want all the channel, right? You just time channel, export to lah, okay? So you want to export this thing, then you need to select what's your export format. So you will be under Microsoft, this. And then I just press export. Then this is the data.
The max one.
Come here.
Max. There's a lock.
So when you click export, you enter the name you exported. So it's under Catman data. Let export. This is your data. Of course, you need to do your own. Auto alignment.
Can you help me see the range different?
So every second, no?
Just at the top and as you go down.
So every second, no? Every second. Okay.
So there is two values here.
Yeah, the two value. This is the time.
So there are two. You are looking at two low cell.
Yeah, looking at two low cell.
Then the time. You get the time start.
Start time.
Because this one, it doesn't tell you what time exactly, right?
Oh no, it's time, it's based on...
So how do we...
You want that one.
Yeah.
You want the exact time.
Is there any information at the top that says what time it started? Then we can add it. Something.
Oh, leh.
So we base it on this guy. Then...
Yeah, this is the start time. Okay. Yeah, so this is the start time. Yeah, these two are the start time. Okay. Yeah, at 1 Hz. Yeah, hardware channel. So these are all the information. So yeah, these are all the data you have. So you need to manipulate because there's too many decimal points. So don't save. So this is how it looks like in the whole graph. So it's slightly going down, so it's a trend. So go back to here. Right. So this is the export computation later. This one you don't need, because there's a lot of things as you move along. If you need, you just need to email us and I will teach you. It's quite easy. So data explorer. Then I just need to close it. Close. Then I go back to Catman again. Okay. So, 刚才你在问, 因为我跟你 set up 到每一秒嘛, so 你 double click 这个东西, 你就可以看了, 这个是 data, 它是在 project. So you may want to have a project shortcut. Create a shortcut. So 你 launch， 这个不要不见哦，很麻烦了。Then, software maintenance， 说你要的话，你要放你的名字、你的 email， so that any update， we will send to you for the whole 1 year， So after that,
so now,
yeah, now is the
turn on. It's like this.
It's
so
like
there are
this
two things we can do. One is start the DAQ. One is to look at the data.
Yeah, analysis is look at the data. You see,
okay,
this
so
is the measure.
Or analysis.
Analysis. So measure is quite easy. Measure you can continue last action. You don't want, you do new. New 就是每次你要做多一次麻烦, but 你每次做的话你当然是会 familiar with the software and then you know all these things. But of course 你每次用 project 的话你久了你就会忘记怎么做 setting up. So I will do again. This is we set, do a new, right? So new, right, you will auto try to look for the quantum X. So if let's say you plug two quantum X, you can see two here, right? So then make sure that this is selected, right? Then you press connect, right? And then you will take a bit of time to connect the thing. Yeah. So once connected, right, we need to assign the sensor to the DAQ. This is called a DAQ. So how to assign? We use a HBM sensor list. We have a lot of sensor, weighing, transducer. Okay. This one, although your load cell is called PW something, but it has the same characteristic as what we have a Z6. So we click on the Z6, and then I go down to your 20 kg version. Right. So I will drag this thing to the channel, but because you have 8 channel, I will select all of them, right, so that you will update all 8 channel together, right. So now you see there is no sensor name. So when I drag over, right, it will update this one to Z6, 30 kg, right. The next thing, right, we should do, right, is do a zeroing. Right. So in before we place a plant on top, we need to press the zero button. Let's say for example now there is no plant. All the skill need to do a zeroing, right? Because if let's say you want to put a piece of thing, you need to zero first.
Well, that means we need to start this new project quite quickly, because we need to zero.
No need to start new project. You can start the
zero la. We need to zero frequently, because we will change plants quite quickly.
So you need to zero lah. So okay, let's say for example we zero. So this is called zeroing all of them together. But if you want to zero one at a time, right, you just select, let's say you want to select this one and then you
pass inside.
Okay. 那个 zero 是 standard 的啊, so
就必须要在那个 new project.
不用啊, 你开新的 project
也可以，
哪里都可以，你几次都可以 zero 的。不用紧的，只是要记得 zero 啊。没有的话，你就会有这个 figure 在这边了。
So step one is to assign the sensor.
Step one assign sensor.
Step
two, right?
Six, 20 kilo.
Step two, right? I will need to.
Step two is step zero.
No, I will do your this thing first.
Step two is the sample rate.
Sample rate. I need
so
to set
configure.
I change to one.
Sample rate 1 hertz.
This is the slow. I want to assign the slow to be 1 hertz. And then choose a filter, right? Because your chamber there's a bit of vibration, so I do a 0.05 hertz.
This is the filter.
This is the filter. So I press OK, right? So now it's just assigning slow to 1 hertz. Now I need to press the slow button so that you see this now still 300 ma. Then you see, yeah, still 300.
Yeah.
So when I press the slow, right, it will change to.
So it's just a
1 hertz.
Quasi power.
So
you choose slow default. Just now we set
slow
to 1 hertz.
Yeah, to 1 hertz.
So now we want to assign the 8 modules to do it in a slow way.
Yeah, in a slow way. So if let's say I go to default, right, it will go back to 300.
Then
I go back to slow. So I'm assigning the as you said, the fuzzy logic thing. So once this one, always do the sampling, filter first before we do zeroing, because this will affect the by result. So now let's say do the sampler rate and filter
first.
Yeah, before we do zeroing. Yeah. This one must always set first after you
before
assign.
We do the
zeroing. Yeah, zeroing. Oh. Yeah. So now assuming that there's no plan, okay. Assuming now no plan.
Mm.
Right? So I will need to press a zero. Once you press zero, all these things will go to zero.
Mm-hmm.
So don't mind, because this is very sensitive. This is less than 1 gram. So actually, don't worry. Because 1 gram, 你的 resolution 是 1 gram. So anything below that, you don't 不重要了。So 现在我们已经做好全部的 setup 了，那我们要 start to 做 recording 啊。So 你可以 record 的，你可以 upfront 现在可以 record， 那你 record 他就会问你，哎，你没有放这个，那我就 go with default 啦，随便啦，不用紧的。那 ignore。所以那些你不要的话，你回去 panel 咯。哎，他现在在 record 呢，都稳定的。我回去 panel， 所以我就
这个是 customize
啊，这个你自己 customize 啊，你自己看呐、啊。不要的话，你就直接用这个，那你的看咯。那你要的话，你就 click 咯。那这些 value 都在这里 ，sorry， 这些 value 都在这里。这个是 real time 的。So real time data 是在这里，全部的 data max value 都在这边。So 你如果你不觉得这个好看的话，你 go back to panel one， we can customize。Then 这个 indicator 就比较容易。So every time you click the indicator， you automatically assign the channel。Right? So I click 8 times， 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 all the channels are assigned。那你自己排哦，自己排。
If we can go online with Wi-Fi, is there a way to send alarm? Is there a certain threshold?
Send alarm to email can.
To email lah.
Yeah.
Email.
Can. You can do that.
Oh, how do we do that?
Okay. 现在越来越 complicated 了，可以。So now you got no problem on this one. These are the basic setup. So if you want more access, just click on this guy. Make sure that there's edit, and then this is highlighted.Go to graph.
Oh, one more thing.
Go to this one and change.
Power shut down.
The data will be still there.
Okay.
Is
there a way to retrieve?
Yeah. When you power shut down, right, you suddenly this one go kisiao, no
voting.
That die or whatever. Or that one die, then it will still keep on recording, but it will tell you there's no communication. The data will be there. If this guy power gone, right, and then when you reboot, right,Once you launch the Catman, right, it will tell you there is a data that you forgot to save. So this is the previous. As you want to save or not, you save. That's it. It's always there. So all this data, right now what you see, right, is actually captured inside a temporary drive. Even though we never save it, right, it will still be there. Right? Then you see, I already assigned 8. So 8 axis is down here. So there's many things for you to play. So take your time and play with it.There's no way I can go through every single one of them in one day. Then you just drag and drop. Just drag. So this is exactly like the project one. So when David comes back, I will do the thing for to set up. So this is it, and then.Can make it bigger, something like that, and then you want to change the time length, right? Then you can go to, you select this one, you go to here, make sure that this is under the x axis, right? X y axis, so x axis, and then you go to instead of 10 seconds, maybe you go to 30 minutes, you will have 30 minutes, yeah. 24 hours, a bit very long, it's up to you, lah. So this is now real value, so right, so done.So let's say you want to do trigger, right? Very simple. This is the data recording. So whenever we want to do setup, you need to stop. Right? It's only on the graph. You do not need to stop. Right? So let's say I need to stop, then I don't want to save. I just discard. Right? So you will say that you will not save. Okay? Yeah, error. Then you go back to here. Right? So you see, there is configure limit.So you can configure
set alarm.
So you see level high crossing 还是 low 咯
set alarm.
哎，怎么了 ？So normally 你们的 alarm 是 low 的，对不对？
嗯。
So you can set low right? New event one, and then 你去这边你的low level crossing, right?So low level crossing. So 你看你有 alarm 有 warning, then 你的 alarm 你可以换 color 啊 all these things 等等等等等等。Right. So alarm level. So let's say 你的那个 port 咯是supposed to be 2 kg 吧。 set anything below 1.9 kg, 你要 set 个 alarm， 所以你就写 1.9 咯，这样而已咯。It's very simple. And then no warning hysteresis， 当然要放一点点了 ，in case 它一直
撞。
Hysteresis 就是那个 graph， 那些你超过 1.9， 它就 set 你 alarm 嘛。那如果你跌一点点的话，又上，它不是相当于一个跌一点点上，是这个是它的 fluctuation 嘛，所以你要放一个 band 啊 ，plus minus 啊，所以你放一个 band 的话 ，let's say maybe history 是 point， 就 200 gram 嘛，所以它上下 200 gram 嘛，不要乱一天到晚就 trigger， 哎、right? ，so with this one right，
when you say trigger， what does it mean 啊？
trigger 就是 send
number or
send action， send you an action， so what type of action now is down here， this is the action part。This is the so this is the condition. This is the action part. So what kind of action you want? So obviously you do not have any output to here. Then you can do log message and then do a log. But if you want to have notification, send email notification or by email, then you can edit. Okay, send to who? Kaki Jo.
So this software can send.
Yeah, send email to anybody, subject, alarm, whatever. You can do this, right? Then you can also do placeholder. What is placeholder? Then right? Placeholder means that you can we have a certain setup. You see, you can do all these things, right? Percentage sign year, percentage sign something like that, and then you can put the exact date that you send out. So there's a lot of things to play around, right? So there you see, this is a placeholder. You want to send the time, the date, the event, that means the event.
What we are concerned is 没有电, so there's no reading or what. Then if there's nobody there, at least someone gets the email and say something is wrong. Yeah.
Or you're concerned?
Or someone accidentally removes something, that means the weight will go down drastically, right?
Yeah,
so close to zero.
Oh, then cannot can do
yeah,
that.
Only this kind of two alarms.
So close to zero, then this is too little lah. Then you of course your condition you set according to your let's say maybe your alarm you set to 0.5 lor. The fella gonna remove right, confirm is less than 0.5.